हेलो बच्चों, वेलकम बैक टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल लर्निंग साइंस विद सीके। मैं हूं आपका टीचर चंदन कुमार और मैं आप लोगों को क्लास सेवन की साइंस पढ़ा रहा हूं। अब तक हम लोगों ने क्लास चैप्टर वन कंप्लीट कर लिया है, ओके, एंड नाउ वी आर स्टडीइंग चैप्टर टू। एंड इन चैप्टर टू वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू ऑल्सो, एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द की वर्ड्स, क्वेश्चन answers, ओके, एंड द समरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, ओके, एंड आफ्टर दिस दिस चैप्टर विल बी कंप्लीटेड, ओके। सो इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरीज रिलेटेड विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज द सेकेंड चैप्टर, न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स एंड न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स, ओके, इन द बोथ चैप्टर, इफ यू हैव एनी टाइप्स ऑफ इशू, प्लीज कमेंट मी योर प्रॉब्लम्स, ओके, so that I can resolve your problems, okay, and in this lockdown period I can help you, okay bachcho, so you open your sim book and open the page number where keywords are written and we will discuss these keywords, okay, and also I will complete one point also that I left earlier, that is diarrhea. I have not told you about the diarrhea, so in this video I will also complete about diarrhea, okay, and then I will start the keywords, okay bachcho, so come to the book and look all the important words. Keywords is what? Keywords is a group of special words which are very relevant with our study, our topic, whatever we are studying, okay. So after understanding these keywords, you will easily handle the chapter, you can understand all the motto and the science behind this, okay, so it's very important, and I think also that this is very important, that's why I are in the last chapter I have not covered the keywords, but I will cover it later. In this chapter I am covering this part also, okay, so come to the book, okay. Hello bachcho, till now we have studied nutrition in animals, we have completed the chapter already, okay, so now we are going to study the keywords, and before that, as I told you, I will told you about one topic, that is diarrhea, okay. Diarrhea is what? I am going to tell you, here is diarrhea. Diarrhea is what, bachcho? Sometimes what happens, you are experiencing the need to pass water stool, okay, frequently. What happens, sometimes you are feeling not well and you are passing watery stool, okay, frequently, and this condition is called diarrhea, okay. Passing the watery stool frequently is called diarrhea, okay. It may be caused by, what are the cause? Infection, any type of infection. It may be food poisoning and or indigestion also. If you eat too much, then also you may suffer with diarrhea, and otherwise if you eat basi food or roadside food, okay, infected food, then also you will suffer with this problem, that is diarrhea, okay. So it is very common in India because the pollution level and the pollutants in our surrounding is too much, our population is also higher, and we all are not managing at high standard of healthy habits, okay, that's why most of kids are suffering from this problem, and it is very common in India, okay, particularly among you children's, okay. And what happens under severe condition, it may be fatal, dangerous, okay bachcho. So please, whenever you are eating food, wash your hands, take proper food, not any basi food or roadside food, okay, or the food in the thelas, okay. Always try to eat the food that is cooked in your home by your mother, okay. And why this is fatal diarrhea? Because due to diarrhea, excessive loss of water and salt from the body takes place, okay. What happens due to watery stool? Excessive amount of salts and
What we say is that is water is being lost, and you know our body has more than 70% water. Okay, and if the water level decrease in our body, then we will suffer this very severe condition. It may be a fatal condition. Okay, so please follow the rules about food habit. Okay, so diarrhea should not be neglected. Definitely, even before a doctor is consulted, the patient should be given plenty of boiled and cooled water. Okay, in your home or in your surrounding, if somebody is suffering from this problem, so please, what you can do, you can make oral rehydration solution, that is called ORS, as you know it by the name ORS, and it is what it is. You can make it in your home using boiled and cooled water. Okay, and what you will mix here, you will mix pinch of salt and sugar. Okay, you will add pinch of salt and sugar and dissolve it, and just you provide to the patient suffering from diarrhea. So before taking the patient to the doctor, use this oral rehydration solution and it will benefit too much. Okay, bacho. Now come to the keywords. You can see here, there are so many keywords are here. Okay, and we will understand all the keywords one by one. Okay, and here, what are the keywords? Keywords are the special words which are very important in the chapter. Okay. For example, these are absorption, amino acid, what is amoeba, what is assimilation, what is bile, what is buccal cavity. We will cover all these words. Okay, so I am going to show you and teach you all these keywords by defining all the words. Okay, one by one. So let's start. And these keywords are starting from absorption. Okay, absorption. What is absorption? Passing of undigested food. Passing of digested food from small intestine and other compartments to the digestive system, to the blood vessels in the wall of small intestine, is called absorption. So absorption is what? Passing of the digestive food from small intestine and other compartment of the digestive system to the blood vessel. So passing of nutrients, digested food from the alimentary canal to the blood vessel through the wall of small intestine and large intestine is called absorption. Okay, bacho. Next word is amino acid. What is amino acid? It is the simplest form of complex protein. Okay, so amino acid is a simplest form of complex protein. Next, amoeba. What is amoeba? Amoeba, it is a single cellular microscopic living organism. Okay, so amoeba is a single cellular microscopic living organism. Next, You can observe amoeba by taking the pond water and watching under the microscope, compound microscope. Okay, next word, assimilation. Assimilation is what? Assimilation means something, using some ingredients, making something special. Okay, so in our body, production of various types of protein using absorbed nutrients from the digested food is called assimilation. Okay, so assimilation is what? Production of various types of protein using absorbed nutrients from the digested food is called assimilation. Okay, next, bile. What is bile? Bile is a digestive juice, and where it is produced? It is produced in liver. And what is the role of this bile? It helps in digestion of fat. Okay, so bile is the digestive juice produced in the liver, which help in the digestion of fat. Next, buccal cavity. So what is buccal cavity? Buccal cavity is the oral space in our mouth, which is made of upper and lower jaw, is called buccal cavity. And what is found inside the buccal cavity? Here, teeth and tongue are present. Okay. Now, next, canine. Canine is what? A special type of teeth. As you know, bachcho, there are four types of teeth in our mouth, and canine is one of them. So, canine is a special type of teeth present in our mouth, used for tearing of the food particle. Okay. And okay, next. Digestion. Before that, one word is cellulose. Cellulose is what? Cellulose is a complex carbohydrate. As you know, there are various types of carbohydrates, simplest to complex. So, cellulose is a complex carbohydrate, and normally this is found in grasses and plants. And as you know, grasses and plants are being eaten by animals, so they are digesting cellulose. Next, digestion. What is digestion? It is the process of breakdown of complex food particle to simplest absorbable form is called digestion. Okay, so digestion is the process of breakdown of complex food particle to simplest absorbable form. What, where it is happening? It's happening in our alimentary canal, in our digestive system. Egestion. Egestion is excretion process. Removal of undigested food particle from body is called egestion. Okay, so egestion is removal of undigested food particle from our body. Next, fatty acid. What is fatty acid? Fatty acid is the simplest absorbable form of fat particle, is called fatty acid. Okay, so fatty acid is simplest absorbable form of fat particle. So fat particle is a complex substance, and fat is made of fatty acid and glycerol. One word again will come about glycerol here, glycerol. So glycerol and fatty acid are the simplest form of fat molecules. Okay, next, food vacuole. What is food vacuole? So food vacuole, it is found in single cellular living organism. Okay, food, as we have digestive system, but single cellular living organism do not have a proper digestive system. So in place of digestive system, they have food vacuole. Okay, and these food vacuoles help in the digestion of food particle. Okay, next, gallbladder. What is gallbladder? Gallbladder is a pouch-like structure which stores the bile juice, and this is released from liver. So bile is produced in the liver, and that is stored in a pouch-like structure that is called gallbladder. Next, glycerol already completed. Incisor. Incisor is also one of the four types of teeth, and the special function of incisor is it help us in biting food items during eating. So biting, okay, biting is done by incisor. Next, ingestion. Ingestion is taking food inside the mouth, is called ingestion. Okay, next, liver. What is liver? Liver, as you know, it is found in our body, and this is the largest gland in human body, which also releases bile juice. And what is the role of bile juice? Bile juice help in the digestion of fat. And also liver is a storehouse, energy storehouse of our body. Okay, next, milk teeth. Milk teeth, everyone, you know, milk teeth are the first teeth originates by birth or after birth with limited lifespan. So after falling down of milk teeth, permanent teeth comes. Okay, Molar is, as I told you earlier, molar is also one of the special type of teeth that is help in chewing food. Okay. Permanent teeth. What is permanent teeth? Permanent teeth are a group of teeth which arises after falling down of milk teeth. Okay. So permanent teeth arises after the falling down of milk teeth. Next, oesophagus. What is oesophagus? As you have learned, it is the connecting food pipe between our buccal cavity and stomach, and it helps in the movement of food particle from buccal cavity to the stomach. Next, pancreas. What is pancreas? It is a cream colored gland. It is a cream colored gland which is attached with the small intestine, where it releases digestive juice. Okay, so pancreas is a colored gland attached with the small intestine, where it releases digestive juice for the digestion of all the important nutrients, that is carbohydrate, protein and fat. Next, premolar. This is the last type of one of the four type of teeth found in human being. And this is a special type of teeth found before the molar teeth, and this teeth help in chewing the food particles. Okay. Next, pseudopodia. What is pseudopodia? Pseudopodia word means made of two words, pseudo and podia. Pseudo means false feet and podia means feet. So pseudo means false and podia means feet. So false feet, and it is formed in amoeba. Okay, and it is formed in amoeba and other single cellular organism which is made of cell membrane. Okay, and it help in movement and ingestion of food. So it help amoeba in taking food inside and moving in the water. Next, rumen. What is rumen? It is a part of stomach found in ruminants. Or who are ruminants? Ruminants are those animals which are eating grass as their food. So grass eating animals or cellulose eating animals are called ruminants. And ruminants have what? Ruminant have a special type of stomach part that is called rumen. And rumen is a special digestive compartment where food is stored. Okay, food is stored and digested. Next, and it help in the digestion with the help of special type of cellulose digesting bacteria. So in the rumen there is a special type of bacteria which help in the digestion of cellulose in cellulose eating animals. Ruminants are it's a noun. Ruminants are what? Ruminants are grass eating animals are called ruminants. Okay, and ruminants are those animals which have rumen as food compartment. Okay, those animals are called ruminant. Next word, related word, rumination. What is rumination? Rumination is the process of digestion of cellulosic food particle with the help of special type of cellulose digesting bacteria. Okay, so rumination is the process of digestion of cellulose food particle with the help of special type of cellulose digesting bacteria. Okay, next, salivary gland. Salivary gland, it's a gland. So it's a name of gland which releases saliva, and it is found in the oral buccal cavity, in the upper and lower part of oral buccal cavity. Next, villi or villi. Villi is what? Villi is a finger like projection in the inner wall of small intestine which increase the surface area for the absorption of food in small intestine. So villi is a projection finger like projection in the inner wall of intestine, and it increases the surface area for the absorption of digested food particles. Saliva is what? Saliva is a mixture. It's a mixture of digestive juice released from salivary gland, and where it is released? In the buccal cavity. So saliva is a mixture of watery mixture with digestive juice, which is released from the salivary gland in buccal cavity. So this is all about the keywords. Okay bachcho, so I have covered all the keywords here. Now I am going to summarize this chapter. Okay, pay attention please. So what are the summary? Animal nutrition include nutrient requirement, mode of intake of food, and its utilization in the body. So what is animal nutrition? Animal nutrition, what happens here? Main thing is requirement of the nutrient, then mode of intake of food means first of all arrangement of nutrient, then taking it inside the body, and then utilization in the body. So this is all process is called animal nutrition. Next, the human digestive system consists of the alimentary canal and secretory glands. So there are two main parts. If we divide the human digestive system, it will be divided in two parts, and first part is alimentary canal and second is secretory glands. So alimentary canal is a canal like process, and secretory glands releasing digestive juices. Okay, so alimentary canal consists of buccal cavity, oesophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine ending in rectum and anus. So it all consists of alimentary canal and secretory glands. Secretory glands are situated in where? Stomach, small intestine, buccal cavity, large intestine. Okay, the main digestive glands which secrete digestive juice are first salivary gland, next liver, third is pancreas. Okay, and one more is that is stomach. The stomach wall and the wall of the small intestine also secrete digestive juice. So glands are salivary gland, liver is also gland, and pancreas are special glands, but along with them stomach wall and small intestine wall also releases secretory digestive juices. Next, the mode of feeding vary in different organisms. As we have studied in various types of animals, taking food is very, very different. Next, nutrition is a complex process involving ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. So there are five steps in nutrition. First of all, taking food, that is ingestion. Then digestion means breaking down of complex food particle into simplest form. Then absorption is absorption of simplest form of nutrients. Then assimilation, making different types of protein using these absorbed nutrients. And egestion is release of undigested food. Next, digestion of carbohydrate like starch begins in the buccal cavity, as we have studied. The digestion of protein start in the stomach as first time. So remember bachcho, this point, carbohydrate digestion start in buccal cavity, protein digestion start in the stomach, and bile that is secreted from the liver, the pancreatic juice from the pancreas, and digestive juice from the intestinal wall complete. These three juices complete the digestion of all components of food in the small intestine. So here in the small intestine, all types of digestion ends, and absorption starts in the small intestine and it ends in large intestine. So the digested food is absorbed in the blood vessel from the small intestine. Okay, next, the absorbed substances are transported to different parts of the body. Okay, along with water, and some salts are absorbed from the undigested food in the large intestine. All the five important nutrients are absorbed from the small intestine and they are being transported to different part of the body after absorption. And water and salt are absorbed in the large intestine. Okay. Next point. The undigested and unabsorbed residue are expelled out of the body as feces through the anus. So this process is called egestion. Okay. Release of undigested and unabsorbed residue. Okay. Next point. The grazing animals like cows, buffaloes and deer are known as ruminants. So as I told you, ruminant is a noun word and it is used for the grazing animals like cows, buffaloes and deers. They quickly ingest, quickly, whenever they are in the field, grass field, they quickly ingest, taking food inside, swallow their leafy food immediately, okay, and store it in the rumen. Rumen is a food compartment in the stomach. Later, the food returns to the mouth and the animal chew it peacefully. So you have seen that whenever grazing animals' stomach is filled, they sit somewhere else under the tree and they are chewing the food again that comes back from the rumen. Next, amoeba ingest its food with the help of its false feet that is called pseudopodia. So with the help of pseudopodia, amoeba ingest its food and the food is digested in the food vacuole. So food vacuole is the space where food digestion takes place of amoeba. So this is all about, we have summarized. Okay, bachcho, you view this, you watch this video 2-3 times again and again so that everything will be very clear for you. Okay, now we are going to start the exercise. Okay, so take a breath and we are again going to start exercise. Okay bachcho, now we will do the exercise in your book NCERT. Okay, so first question is fill in the blanks. And under it, A option A, question A is the main steps of nutrition in humans are, what are the main steps of nutrition in humans? What will be, just you think, I am going to tell you. And answer is the main steps of nutrition in humans are ingestion, means taking food inside, digestion, means breaking down of complex food particles into smaller one, simpler substance, then absorption of nutrients, then assimilation, making new proteins, and last is egestion, means excretion of waste food particle. Okay, so this will be the answer: egestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. See the difference, ingestion and egestion. Okay, come to the next question. B, the largest gland in the human body is, what will be? Liver. Okay, so largest gland in the body is liver. Its weight is approx 1.5 kg. Question number C, the stomach releases hydrochloric acid and digestive juice. So what juice? Digestive juices, which act on food. Question number D, the inner wall of the small intestine has many finger like outgrowth called villi. Okay, villi or villi. E, amoeba digest its food in the food vacuole. Okay, in the food vacuole. Now question number 2, mark T if the statement is true and if it is false. Okay, so option number A, digestion of starch start in the stomach. True or false? It is false, because digestion of starch start in, not in the stomach, in mouth. Okay, question B, the tongue help in mixing food with saliva. The tongue help in mixing food with saliva. Is it true or false? It is true. Question C. The gallbladder temporarily store bile. Yes. Gallbladder temporarily store bile, which is used for the digestion of fat. Question D. The ruminants bring back swallowed grass into their mouth and chew it for some time. Is it true or false? Yes, it is true. As you know, ruminants bring back swallowed grass into their mouth and chew it for some time to help in complete digestion. Now, question number 3. Mark the correct answer in each of the following. A. Fat is completely digested in the... Where fat is completely digested? Stomach? No. Mouth? No. Small intestine? Yes. Fat is completely digested in the small intestine. Question number B. Water from the undigested food is absorbed mainly in the... Where water is completely mainly absorbed? Stomach? No. Food pipe? No. Small intestine? No. So, large intestine? Yes. Question number 4. Match the items of column 1 with those given in column 2. Column 1, column 2. Column 1 is of food component and column 2 is products of digestion. Means, these are the complex forms and these are the simplest form. So, carbohydrates, simplest form will be, first one is fatty acid, no, sugar, yes. So, carbohydrates, simplest form is sugar. Now, protein, you have two or more options left. So, protein, product of digestion is for protein, is it fatty acid and glycerol? No. Is it amino acid? Yes. So, proteins. Product of digestion is amino acids. Now only one left here, fats, and here fatty acid and glycerol, and this is the correct match. Fats, product of digestion is fatty acids and glycerol. Question number 5. What are villi? Okay, villi. And next question is, what is their location and function? So, villi, what is villi? Villi are the finger-like projections found in the inner layer, inner wall of the small intestine. And this is about its location. And what is its function? Its function is to provide maximum surface area for the absorption of food. Okay, so I'm telling you again, villi is finger like projections found in the inner wall of small intestine, and its function is providing maximum surface area for the absorption of food. Question number 6. Where is the bile produced? Bile is produced in liver. Okay. Which component of the food does it help to digest? You all know what it is? Fat. Okay. Fat. Question number 7. Name the type of carbohydrate that can be digested by ruminants but not by humans. Name the type of carbohydrate that can be digested by ruminants. So, ruminants can digest what? Cellulose. Ruminants can digest cellulose, but we cannot. Okay. Give the reason. And reason is that we don't have rumen as a compartment in our stomach. And next reason is that we don't have cellulose digesting bacteria in our stomach. That's why we cannot digest cellulose. Okay. Question number 8. Why do we get instant energy from glucose? So answer will be, we get instant energy from glucose because glucose is the simplest form of carbohydrate, and it is the in the condition of directly it is being directly absorbed without any process of digestion. Okay, so there is no need to digestion, so no more time is required, and it is easily absorbed from the inner wall of small intestine and directly used by our body cells for release of energy. Okay, are you satisfied? Question number 9. Which part of the digestive canal is involved in? So you have to tell that which part, which compartment is involved in this particular function. So first question is absorption of food. So absorption of food takes place in small intestine. Okay, now chewing of food is in which compartment, digestive compartment? It is in buccal cavity. Killing of bacteria is done in stomach by acid. Complete digestion of food. So complete digestion of food takes place in where? Small intestine. Fifth, formation of feces takes place in large intestine. Okay, so you got all the answers. Question number 10. Write one similarity and one difference between nutrition in amoeba and human being. Okay, similarity is that as all living organisms, amoeba and humans both required nutrients, and nutrients are the same: carbohydrate, protein, fat, okay, minerals, vitamins, same. Okay, and second is similarity is that in both digestion process takes place. Okay, difference is that amoeba is a single cellular organism and human is a complex organism. So amoeba has no digestive system. Amoeba has a simplest digestive system, that is food vacuole. But human beings have a complete digestive system, advanced digestive system. Okay, so this is the difference. Now question number 11. Match the items of column 1 with suitable item in column 2. Okay, you have to match the column 1 with column 2. A, salivary gland, you have to match from column 2. Bile juice, no. Storage of undigested food, no, it's not the function of salivary gland. Saliva secretion, yes, function of salivary gland is saliva secretion. B, stomach, what is the function of stomach? Bile juice secretion, no. Storage of undigested food, no. Acid release, yes, stomach function is release of acid takes place in stomach. Liver function, you have option bile juice secretion, yes, liver secrete bile juice. Now you have four options left. Rectum, storage of undigested food, yes, exactly we got the answer here. Now E, small intestine, and you have three options left. Digestion is completed, yes, in the small intestine digestion completes. Now F, large intestine, options, two options you have: absorption of water and release of feces. So what is the function of large intestine? Its function is absorption of water, not the release of feces. Okay, release of feces takes place from anus. Okay, question number 12. Label figure 2.11 of the digestive system. So you have to label the names here. So we are starting to label. This is all the complete digestive system of human being, and it start from this part is called what it is called? It is called oesophagus. I am repeating oesophagus. Next this J-shaped structure is called what it is called? Stomach. Okay, stomach. Now next is here it is a pouch sac like structure, and it is what? It is gall bladder. Okay, gall bladder. Next, stomach opens in which canal? It is called small intestine. Okay, next is what? This cream shaped structure, this is pancreas. Okay, what it is? Pancreas. Now continuing the small intestine. Now we got a larger intestine, and it is called larger intestine. Small intestine here is large intestine. Okay, now large intestine, we are moving in large intestine. Now comes this region is called where storage takes place of undigested food. It is called rectum. Okay, rectum. Now only one part left, that is called anus. Okay, so I am repeating once again. First part oesophagus, then stomach then gallbladder, after that it is small intestine, this cream shaped structure is pancreas, then comes large intestine, after that comes rectum, and end is anus. Okay, so we have completed up to the question number 12. Last question is, can we survive only on raw leafy vegetables or grass? No, we cannot survive on grass and raw leafy vegetables because we don't have rumen like structure in our stomach which can digest grass. Okay, or we don't have the cellulose digesting bacteria. Grass contains cellulose. Okay, and cellulose, to digest cellulose, we need rumen and cellulose digesting bacteria, which is found in ruminants like goat, cow and deer, but we don't have, so we cannot survive on only leafy vegetables and grass, only raw leafy vegetables and grass. Okay, we can eat leafy vegetable after only by cooking. Okay, so answer will be no. So this is all about this chapter, bachcho. I hope that you have learned well and pay attention properly. So I request you all to please watch this video 3 to 5 times. Okay, I am repeating 3 to 5 times so that you can able to understand and get all the points very easily, and you can complete your study at home. So thank you, bachcho, for studying with me. You given me time, and I'm helping you to complete your study during this lockdown period. So thank you very much. I am once again repeating that you watch this video 3 to 5 times. Okay, so that whenever your school will open, you will easily be able to write the exams without any extra study. Okay, so thank you, bachcho. And if anybody of you is new to my channel, please subscribe to the channel so that next video, which I am uploading every next day in the early morning 6 a.m. okay, it will be available from 6 a.m. onwards every second day or every alternate day. Okay, so please you all subscribe the channel and be with me so that I can help you in your studies. Thank you once again. Bye bye.